In section 1.3.4, we will discuss the fundamental theorem for divergences. We have already done the fundamental theorem for gradients. Now, this is the fundamental theorem for divergences. This is a fundamental theorem because it relates the volume integral to a surface integral, and this is critically important in electrodynamics, where we are concerned with the flow of something. Here, for example, the divergence of electric field lines, the divergence from a charge distribution. So this basically gives us a flux, and flux in the form of flow, whether it's a flow of charges, it's a flow of field lines, and this is called a Green's theorem or the flux theorem or the divergence theorem. So different names are associated to it. This is also called as Gauss's theorem. So this theorem states that if we are having a volume integral and a quantity is diverging in a given volume, let's say this is quantity V, a vector function, it is diverging in a given volume, and we integrate the divergence in that volume, then this is equal if we consider a closed surface, means a surface integral, and we take that quantity directly in the cross-sectional area or the flux of that quantity. So this is the fundamental theorem for divergence. Now, what does this means actually? That let's say we are having a vector function, a physical quantity, and this physical quantity, how much it is diverging in a given volume, we integrate the divergence. Then this will be equal if we take that quantity itself and take its dot product with its cross-sectional area, means the flux of that quantity through the closed surface. Now, is in example, I can take, for example, if I take an incompressible fluid, like for example water, and then that water is contained in a given container, so it is having some volume. Now, how much is the volume of that water? I will just, you can say, find the dimensions of it and will calculate this volume. The other way is to calculate content of water, for example, then is to pass it through some, you can say, let's say tape, and then measure the cross-sectional area of it, then how much water is passing through it, then it will be calculated again, means the content of water can be calculated in that manner as well. But we will discuss this thing with respect to the electrodynamics. In electrodynamics, let's say we are having a spherical surface, and although it is very hard to make this thing in a three dimension, okay, let's say this is a spherical surface and this is the center of it, and we are having a source at the center of this. Now, this is, let's say, our axes, our x, y, and z axes are here. This is our x, this is y, and this is z axis. Now, if I'm having a charge distribution, this is the charge distribution, which is exactly at the center of it. And now this distribution of charge, the electric field lines are diverging from this one. Like the electric field lines are diverging first these ways, then for example, they are diverging in this direction, they are diverging in this direction, diverging in this direction, and diverging in this direction. Similarly, they are diverging in these directions as well, means the divergence is such that it is in all the direction, it is three-dimensional, its divergence is. Similarly, the other directions are possible as well. I will make as many lines as to show the geometry of this divergence. And here these lines are. And similarly here and here as well. Now, how much? This is our charge distribution. This is our charge density, and now this density is diverging in different directions. Now, how much is the diverge in this whole volume? It is given by this side. And now, if for example, I take a surface element on the surface of this sphere, and this is, let's say, the area element on the surface of this sphere, then how many lines are passing? This is dA here. This is dA, and it's a vector quantity. And then how many lines are passing through this one, and what angle they are making? The dot product will give us this thing. And it will also tell me that how much is this quantity diverging from this sphere. So there are two ways to calculate this thing, that either we do calculate this thing with the help of the volume. So if I want to calculate in the whole volume, then I will write the divergence in the whole volume and I will write the left side of this equation. But if I want to calculate this one with ease, then I will take that quantity and then I will calculate it through the surface of it, and then it will give me the exact same amount of that quantity or the flux of that quantity. So basically the divergence theorem is dealing with the flow of something. So it is the flux or the cross-sectional area. I can take here the example, let's say this physical quantity that we are dealing is the electric field that we are dealing. So I can write that this equation will become the volume integral, and then it will be the divergence of electric field in the whole volume, and this is equal to a closed surface integral, and this will be E dot dA. I calculate that electric field directly on the surface, and here I will have to calculate the divergence of that electric field in a given volume. So this is all the lines are actually electric field lines. So this is telling us that if we calculate the flux of the electric field on the surface, it will give the same result if we calculate the divergence of this electric field in the given volume. And in order to understand that this is true, then we will have to solve example 1.10. So example 1.10 is telling us, let me recite this example, and this example is saying, check the divergence theorem using the function v equals y square in x unit vector plus 2xy plus z square in y unit vector and 2yz in z unit vector, and the unit cube situated at the origin. is shown in figure 1.29. So we are having a vector, and that vector is equal, this is a vector function or a vector which is equal to y square and x unit vector plus 2xy plus z square and y unit vector and 2yz and z unit vector, and we will have to evaluate this one on a unit cube. So let's say first design the unit cube here, and the unit cube is here. Let's say we are having and now these are our x, y, and z axes. So this is x axis, this is the y axis, and this is the z axis. And we know it's a unit cube, so these values are 1 here. And now the coordinates of it will be like, if we are considering the faces of it, then the faces of it are, let's say, along the x-axis, we are having, this is the first face along the x-axis, so it will be 1. And then along the opposite x-axis, this will be 2. Then we are having the 3 along the y axis, and 4 will be along the negative y axis. Similarly, 5 along the z axis, and the bottom face is the 6th one, the last one, which is along the minus z axis. And this is our unit cube. And now we will take this as our function, and we will find its divergence in the whole volume in this one, and then it will give us, means we will then integrate it in the whole volume of this cube, and that will give us the left side of that equation. And then for the right side of this equation, we will take the faces, all the faces of this one, and we will calculate the flux of our function, and we will come to know that this one, the both the sides are giving us the same result, and then our theorem will be proved for this one. So let's first find the divergence of this vector. This is divergence of V, and divergence of V, I know that this is equal to curly by curly X in X plus curly by curly Y in Y, and then plus curly by curly Z in Z axis, and then it's a dot product with this, so Y square in X plus 2XY plus z square and y and plus 2yz and the z axis, and this is finally here. Now this divergence will come out to be, means the internal components will multiply, so x unit vector will become 1, and the derivative of x, the y square with respect to x, is equal to 0. Plus, then this component will be multiplied with this one. So when it is derivated with respect to y, then it comes out to be 2x. And then when this one is derivated with respect to y, it gives 0. So we got 2x here. And then plus, y dot y will become 1 here. Then now z dot z becomes 1. And then its derivative with respect to z will come out to be 2. y. So this comes out to be 2x plus 2y, or I can write 2 times x plus y. So the dot, the divergence of it comes out to be this. Now let's integrate this on the whole volume. So we have on a whole volume, the divergence of V and fractional volume to integrate on d term, this is equal to integral on a whole volume and then 2x plus y, and then we are having the volume is dx dy and dz here. Now we will integrate this one. So the first one is, we know that we are having the volume is the x, y and z here. Here we are having x and y. So first we will integrate this x plus y and dx. Then the whole equation will be converted into y. And then we will integrate this along y. And after that we will integrate it along dz here. I can write this integral in different dx, dy, dz like this, that this is 2, and now integral along x axis, so 0 to 1, integral along y axis 0 to 1, and integral along z axis 0 to 1, and then x plus y and dx, dy and dz here. So I will first find the x part here, and the x part is from 0 to 1, and this is x plus y dx then, and this is equal to 0 to 1 x dx plus 0 to 1 y dx here. So this is equal to half x squared and from 0 to 1 plus this one is y times x, and from 0 to 1, and this comes out to be 1 minus 0. So this is half plus 1 minus 0, so y is, x is 1, so this is half plus y. And similarly, I can, now this half plus y is the result of this thing. So here for this I, for x plus y dx, I will have to know write half plus y and then dy dz.